American universities and colleges have received billions of dollars from foreign countries and adversaries. Three of the top five countries that have pumped money into higher education here in the U.S., China, Qatar, and Saudi Arabia. Joining us right now with more on this is CEO and founder of OpenTheBooks.com, Adam Andrzejewski. Good morning to you, Adam. And we should also point out that the three of the top five schools receiving the money are also Ivy League schools. So break this down with first how much money we're talking about.
So foreign influence on gifts and grants since 1990 is a big number. It's $43 billion. And roughly one out of every four of those foreign gifts and grants have come from those three countries who oftentimes don't have U.S. interests at heart. They're adversarial to our foreign policy positions and the American way of life. And that's Qatar, Saudi Arabia, and China. Just since 2017, actually, those three countries have put an additional $3.3 billion into America's institutions of higher ed. And, you know, since 1990, they've put $7 billion worth of money. So the pace of the gifts is actually increasing.
Qatar has put in more than $5 billion, according to some of these recent numbers. Who are the top universities receiving the most foreign gifts and grants?
Well, you've got, since 2017, you've got four actually out of the top five that are Ivy League institutions led by Yale, Harvard, Cornell. So since 2017, just Harvard, Cornell, and Yale have basically split $2.6 billion, nearly equally, with Yale coming out slightly ahead in the number one position. But since 1990, just those three institutions have split. And if you add the University of Pennsylvania, they've split $7 billion. So these are our crown jewel institutions.
What's the most troubling situation you found after reviewing all this data?
So it has to be the University of Texas A&M. So who knew you can be an Aggie and get a degree studying at the Texas A&M campus, not in Texas, but actually in Qatar. They circumvented the state legislature. They put in a degree conferring campus in Qatar, and then they tried to cover it up. Judicial Watch had to sue them to find out who in Qatar paid the university $500 million, $520 million in foreign gifts and grants. Texas A&M was only reporting one-tenth of that on the federal mandated reporting websites.
And there's a lot of questions and concerns, obviously, when you're dealing with these foreign gifts and grants, especially when you consider the influence, as you mentioned, another country could have on our higher education system. So what did you find in regards to that? How much influence are they having?
Well, it's hard to get into an Ivy League institution, but it certainly looks like countries that are adversarial to U.S. positions can buy their way in. And so, you know, the risks run from military secrets to the latest in technology breakthroughs, to a treasure trove of intellectual property reserves, and of course, Jan, the number one asset of the country, our young minds.
What steps are being taken, Adam, to safeguard American universities and assets?
Well, during the Trump administration, Education Secretary Betsy DeVos, she kicked this off in 2020, and she forced the universities to comply with federal transparency reporting. So that's number one. You have to report your gifts. An additional $6.5 billion of gifts she forced universities to report. The second thing that you need to do is establish a relationship with your local FBI, and then you need to educate your university employees on the risks, establish a committee, and vet the foreign entities before doing business with them. And thankfully, the Biden administration is continuing to elevate this issue. Just last month, the Department of Defense issued guidance to the universities, a watch list of the foreign entities to be on the look for that have caused us problems.
Founder and CEO of OpenTheBooks.com, Adam Andrzejewski. Great to see you. Have a great weekend. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, Jan.